Hi guys, Neci LoveHarmon here of Whatsshecreating Enterprises, and today I will be giving you as much information as I can about sewing needles. Now, first off, let me tell you, sewing needles are different from hand needles because the top of the needle is very heavy and then the bottom is very light. Let's go over a little bit of general information about sewing needles. So if you look at the bottom of the sewing machine needle, it has a hole and then there is a very pointed tip. Okay, this is what punctures the fabric so that your top thread and your bottom thread come together and create a seam. All right, at the top, there is a flat side here. And then there is a more concave side this way. If you look at the writing on here, it can tell you the size of the needle. I'm going to go over that in this presentation and talk to you about size of needles because that is what really matters. Now, where do you put this sewing machine needle? So I'm going to move over to my sewing machine here. And if I zoom in, there we go. That is where the sewing machine needle goes. My other tutorials, I go more into depth as to how to insert a sewing machine needle. So check those videos out at your leisure. So let's move on. A lot of people may ask, well, what type of sewing machine needles should I use? Well, I'm using a Kenmore 385 series sewing machine here. And as you can see, I have Schmitz type needles, and then these are just basic universal type needles, but you see that there are different sizes on here. So from my perspective, I use whatever needle I can find that's of the right size. It doesn't matter if it's Singer or whatever, as long as it fits in my machine and it doesn't break when I'm sewing, then that's the type of needle that I will use. Now if you look at my chart here, move this out of the way. If you look at my chart here, there are really four different sizes of needles. There's the size 9, the 11, the 14, and the 16. These are the most commonly known sizes. And within these different four sizes, you can get the 9 ballpoint or the 9 universal. So they have the ballpoint 11 as well as the blue, which is more like the universal. They have the ballpoint 14 and the ballpoint in the red. 14, they also have the wide point 16 and the wide and the green. So those are the different types of needles that you can get for the different sizes. And then there's also a top stitching needle that you can get in size 11 and size 14. And then there's a size 18 needle, and this is mostly for your larger weights. Let me show you the difference between a 9 and a 16. The size 9 needle on my left, and then the size 16 needle on the right. And you can see the difference in the size. You see how the 16 is a lot wider on the right than the size 9 on the left. And that's because the 16 is for a larger type of material, a heavyweight leather and a canvas, and the size 9 needle is for your sheer weights like your mesh and your organza and things like that. Okay guys, so let's talk about fabric type and sewing needle. All right, because that's the most important thing. So with your size 9 needle, you will sew very light fabrics. Here's an example of some tulle. So you would use your size 9 needle for tulle, georgette, chiffon, organdy, lace, and other fine fabric. So for my soft single knits, I will use a size 11 needle, but you can also use it for swimwear, tricot, taffeta, satin, silk. Those are your size 11 fabric. Size 14 is starting to get more heavier, so I would use it for my denims. I could also use it for my double knit, sweater knits, my leather, vinyl, and suede. Those are some of the type of fabrics I would use with the size 14 needle. For the size 16 needle, I usually do it for my heavier vinyl, leather, suede, as well as I could use it for or canvas, duck fabrics, upholstery fabrics, and the like. So I hope that this tutorial assists you in your sewing needle journey. So leave us a comment, follow us on Instagram or Facebook, subscribe to our page, and like our video, and happy sewing!